So I read a story recently about a young couple that had just brought their first baby home. As excited as they were to start this new phase of life together, the husband was actually pretty scared and feeling stressed out about it. On the first day on their own at home with this new baby, the wife changed several diapers before finally asking her husband if he'd like to try changing one. I'm busy. I'll change the next one, he tells her. So a couple hours later, when the baby's diaper needed to be changed, she asked him again, "You ready to change this diaper?" The husband looked at his wife a little puzzled and finally said, "Oh, I didn't mean the next diaper. I meant the next baby." Adding a new family member is, as wonderful as it is, can also be really stressful. So can getting married, starting a new job, changing houses or cities. Change can be tough on us. In session six, I want you to spend some time considering all the ways that your life has changed in recent years and how those changes may be adding to your stress. Changes that you view as negative might be the most obvious for you to identify: death of a loved one, a divorce, losing your job, new health problems. Be careful not to minimize any of these changes by telling yourself that it's no big deal or that you should be able to handle it. You're not trying to critique your resilience. You're simply trying to accurately identify the sources of stress that you've experienced in recent years. Don't deceive yourself by pretending that a major life change wasn't stressful to you. And don't shame yourself because you think you should be able to handle these things. Change is difficult for everybody. While the negative changes may stand out in your mind, you also need to identify the positive changes you've experienced recently and acknowledge the stress that those changes may have caused on you. Maybe you've been working hard at your job and you've just been given a promotion. That's wonderful news, right? That can also be a stressful change with new responsibilities, new expectations, maybe a new work schedule. Or maybe you finally retired after decades of working full-time. This is a huge accomplishment and such an exciting time for you. You can finally give more time to your spouse or your hobbies or church ministries, or you can finally write that book you've always wanted to write. But after 30 or 40 years of a routine, of structure, of knowing what to do each day and how to do it, retirement can actually be a little frightening and stressful. Don't downplay it or minimize it. Don't shame yourself for not feeling on top of the world when things go well for you. It might not make sense, but it's true. Victories are often stressful. On my own journey, it was a series of major life changes, some positive, some negative, that initially knocked me off balance. Anne and I were living in a small town in Idaho, raising our first two children. I had a good job. We were deeply involved in the life of our church. We had a great group of friends, most of whom were about our age and raising young kids just like us. Life was very stable. Then, in about a two-month window, our third child was born. Anne's youngest brother passed away from leukemia, and we moved for a new job. Now, Sam's death was clearly a negative change, and it involved loss and grief. But two of these changes are positive, right? We welcomed a new baby into the family, and I got a new job, a job I had been preparing for several years. Let's look at some ways that each of these positive changes could have been stressful for me. So Josh wasn't a surprise baby. He was planned, he was much anticipated, and we were grateful beyond words for his arrival. But he was new. Now he had three kids to think about, three kids to plan around, to feed, to buy clothes for, to give attention to. The jump from one to two wasn't a giant leap in our workload, but going from two to three was huge. We were outnumbered for the first time. And for the third time in our young marriage, we were back to crying babies, sleepless nights, and the frustration of not knowing what this little person wants from us. Josh has been a wonderful part of our family, but it wasn't easy in the beginning. And then there's the new job. Think about all the stressors that come with a new job in a new city. First, you have to sell your home, which is no picnic and is emotionally draining. Then there's leaving the town and the people and the church and the work that have all become so familiar. Just cutting ties, breaking relationships, and walking away from the familiar. Moving to a new city involves starting all over again. New city, new culture, new people, new friends, new church, all new routines. Then you have to try to find a new home to live in, and that can be one of the most stressful things we ever do. And finally, you have to learn the ins and outs of the new job, new responsibilities, new colleagues, new ways of doing things. All this newness challenges our homeostasis, our stability, which is the very definition of stress. Okay, let's review a couple take-home points from today's session. First, all changes cause stress, both good change and bad change. Acknowledging major life changes and their impact on you is an important aspect of building resilience. minimizing them or shaming yourself over them only hurts you. And then finally, what seems like a single change, like starting a new job, when it's unpacked, may actually entail a long list of changes, all of which challenge your balance and cause you stress. The bottom line is that change is stressful, and we need to take it into account as we work toward wellness. All right, let me pray for you as you get started on your discussion questions today. God, we thank you for the good changes that come into our lives, the things we've requested and prayed for and petitioned you for, like new babies and marriages and new jobs and new homes, but we know all this newness can knock us off balance, can throw us out of our homeostasis and cause us stress. I pray that we wouldn't beat ourselves up over those things or how we're responding to them, but that we would understand that that's just part of the way human beings are, and we'd acknowledge it and we'd take it into account as we work toward wellness. We also thank you, we do, honestly, thank you for the way you work through the negative changes. As hard as those negative changes are, the loss, the grief, the things that we didn't want changing, but that changed nonetheless, Lord, we know that you work through all those things for our good, that it's through those extreme challenges that you really sharpen us and make us a better tool in your hands. So God, give us that attitude as we face all the various changes. Help us to be real honest about them and put them forward in front of you. We can figure out together by your Spirit, Lord, which ones go on the can change list and which go on the cannot change list, right? Which changes did we have control over? Which changes did we not have control over? That we'd release the ones that are beyond us completely to you. And the ones that we have some control over, we'd accept responsibility for those and we'd courageously deal with them. Thank you for this group and their willingness to dive into this material. Just give them a real blessing tonight as they dig deep. May your Spirit be the one that guides the conversation tonight. It's in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. All right, guys. Enjoy all you're doing tonight. Love you. Hope to see y'all soon.